It's Wes. Welcome to another video. Today we're going to look at which camera performs better in high ISO situations to compensate for low light, the Canon 5D Mark IV or the Canon EOS R. You're a beautiful person and a good person, and if no one has told you that today, let me be the first one to tell you that. Set up in the kitchen, and I was trying to replicate a whiskey glass bottle photo shoot I did. That's actually on my Instagram, the original one. I had two Godox SL60 lights and a ring light that I use for overhead light. So the Godox 60 SL60s I positioned kind of at 45 degree angles coming in. But I did make a mistake. I moved one of those that had in the previous shot been kind of a backlight. I moved it to the front. So I didn't get a good, nice outline of light from the backlight like I did in the first shoot, but that was my mistake. So I poured the whiskey and I lined up the bottles in the background so I could shoot through the whiskey glasses and kind of replicate that shot I had before. Now, on both the EOS R and the 5D Mark IV, I used the same settings. And what I wanted to do is cut out a lot of the bright light from the SL60s and just have it kind of accentuate the lines and the ridges on the bottles. And so I used F16 to shut out all that light. But then I cranked up the ISO to compensate. And I was trying to see in a low light situation where you're using high ISO, and I kind of faked it, I approximated it by using such a small opening on the shutter, the F16. And so I wanted to see the 5D Mark IV or the Canon EOS R, which one did better in low light. Now, when I first took the pictures, I only used the EOS R and I took some at 10,000 ISO, and I noticed that there was a lot of grain, which 10,000, that's very, very high. So when I came back for this experiment, I put both cameras at ISO 4000, which helped me accomplish my goals for the shoot. But I also wanted to see, are those images usable? Which one compares better in terms of grain and noise introduced in the final product? So let's take a look. All right, when I got the images into Lightroom, I made a few basic adjustments. One, the top of the image was so dark, I had to increase the exposure, but I also played with increasing the shadows. And I was really trying to bring out the detail around the stems of the bottles. And so I found there was a couple of tools that were handy for that. One was using the texture brush versus increasing the exposure around there. The exposure boosted the grain a lot on both images. And so I used the texture brush around there. I did some brushing on the actually whiskey itself, and I increased the exposure there. I put a little radio filter on the lighter label to boost it because it was kind of behind the other whiskey bottle. But basically what I found is when you increase exposure, you get grain. And so the best thing I found to do was to actually have a gradient filter from the top down, increase the exposure, but then drop the blacks. And what that helped is kind of bring out where there's already a little bit of light on the stems of the bottles. It brings that out, but then the black background, it preserves that by dropping the blacks. Now, let's see how they actually compared up close. Ultimately, in the end, finally, the EOS R is more sensitive to light, and therefore there's actually more grain in the EOS R image. Now, it's very close, and if you're shooting raw, those differences are negligible in Lightroom. When I process both images, you can't really tell the difference in the quality of the image. The actual surprising part, the thing that made the most difference, was the ergonomics of the camera. You can see in these final two images, I couldn't get as low with the 5D, and so the perspective comparing the glasses to the bottles is different. It's personal preference. I like the perspective I got with the EOS R, which was I was able to get lower to the surface that everything was resting on, so the glasses seem higher compared to the profile of the bottles. But that's just me. So ultimately, I'm going to say the 5D is better in low light. There's less grain, but that's because the EOS R is more sensitive. If you want to see the video where I really first discovered that, you can click up here and watch that video. But I just want to say thanks for joining. Both cameras are amazing. Both cameras I had a blast shooting with. Of course, the flip screen makes shooting on the EOS R so much easier than the 5D, but the 5D is also a great camera. Thanks for joining me. Click the like button, leave me a comment, and let me know your experience shooting in low light. I actually did some footage in terms of filming, and I was going to compare them, but I'll save that for another video. All right, subscribe, leave a comment, like, and share this video with somebody who's interested in the 5D or the EOS R. Thanks. I'll see you next time.